fun, generally speaking. I mean, especially with the panels. Like, I mean, do you know how we come up with the panel schedules? This is something I feel like it's really important to let people know about. If there is a panel that, and you're looking over the sheet in the list, and you see a panel that doesn't exist, if you see there's a hole in your heart that is reflected by the panel guide. I mean, that's what when we say we're requesting panels, we don't just mean other people. We mean every person who comes to the show has a say in what the programming is. So if you want to do a panel about our culture, or if you want to get some people from the CAM in to talk about this kind of stuff, fucking, no, there is not a thing in the universe that can stop you.
I have my information, so if you want to contact me, I would love to organize that.
But what I'm saying is that next year, when we ask for panel stuff, put it in, and I will shepherd that thing through the system. I mean, that part of it, that's a part of the role-playing culture, which is a part of the table culture, which is something that we really try to support. I've had positive experiences. They ended pretty well, I think. I'm not going to go into it. But I think it's perfectly acceptable to bring that kind of a message and to communicate to people. You know, I think a lot of people assume that they wouldn't like it, but it's quite possible to enjoy it.
I have to say, if you like D&D and role-playing around the table, LARP is just the same thing. You just
Do this panel next year. And then immediately after the panel, a lot of times the tabletop panels will be like, hey, come see us in the tabletop room. Let's get it out. Just get them all together. Go out into the park. Fight each other.
and there are many other types of LARP other than vampires.
No. There's also dark pyre. Night biters.
Hitting people with foam tar pipes is really cool too.
See, exactly.